can be frustrating when you send off your campaign emails and get very little engagement, such as clicks or purchases, or worse yet, you get spam complaints and unsubscribes. This video should help with the negative responses to your email campaigns and increase your deliverability. Step one, though, is to understand a few terms: delivery versus deliverability. Delivery means that MailChimp successfully sent your email to the recipient's server, and it passed all of the appropriate steps. Deliverability refers to the ability of your email to arrive in your contact's inbox. The third term to beware of is the sender reputation. A sender reputation is a score assigned to your account based on how your contacts interact or engage with your emails. This includes both positive and negative interactions. Improving your sender reputation will also improve your email deliverability. So how do you do that? Here are 6 tips to help you. Number 1, don't buy a list and make the assumption that all will be good. Firstly, MailChimp's omnivore system can sniff out paid lists and shut your account down for violating its terms of service. Secondly, your spam complaints and unsubscribes will be very high, which will significantly lower your sender reputation. Tip number 2, verify your email domain address and authenticate the domain associated with your email address. Now, this is probably the little bit more technical part of this, but verifying your email address is very straightforward. To send email through MailChimp, you need to verify that you are using a valid from email address hosted at a domain you can access. This helps keep your campaigns out of spam folders and protects your reputation by ensuring others can't use your domain without permission. You only need to verify a domain one time, then you can send with any email address at the verified domain. A more technical component to this, and it is optional, is to authenticate your domain. Domain authentication helps your emails reach your recipients' inboxes. Adding authentication to the domain you use to send emails can help you maintain and grow an engaged audience. Although this process is optional, it is recommended for MailChimp users with domains registered and managed outside of MailChimp. Authentication can only be added to domains you or your business own and control. Email addresses at public email services like Gmail, Yahoo, and AOL aren't able to be authenticated through MailChimp. For example, I use my business email address, larry@larrysnow.me. I verified I'm the owner of that email, and I'm using Google Workspace as my email domain server to send and receive emails. To authenticate your domain, you'll need to copy and paste information from MailChimp into your domain's records. Depending on your domain provider, the steps and information you need to create your records with may vary. MailChimp does provide you with a customized instructions based on the service you use, and if your service isn't listed, you can choose the other, which will supply you with generic set of steps to guide you through. Tip number 3, maintain a healthy audience. It's best to have one audience that you organize with tags, groups, or segments rather than maintain multiple audiences in your account. MailChimp treats all audiences in your account separately, and billing is based on the total number of contacts across all of your audiences, with of course the exception of archived and clean contacts. If you have duplicate contacts across audiences, having one audience could save you money. One audience is also easier to manage and keep clean. Another step to keep a healthy audience is re-engage or unsubscribe inactive subscribers. MailChimp strongly recommends that you periodically re-engage inactive subscribed contacts to confirm their interest in your business or product. If your inactive subscribers don't respond to your re-engagement campaign, it's best to unsubscribe them. For example, you can use a segment to filter out those who haven't opened any of the last campaign emails that were sent. Another step to a healthy audience is send tailored campaigns. When you send it to segments in your audience, subscribers receive the content they're most interested in. You can send email campaigns to subscribers based on their open and click behavior, subscriber profile preferences, and e-commerce purchases, among other variables. If you use tags to organize your audience, you can send directly to your tag contacts or create segments based on the tag data in your audience. Tip number 4, use personalized merge tags. Using the merge tag for the first name of your contacts in your email helps avoid spam filters and increases engagement. Tip number 5, send a welcome email. When someone signs up for your email marketing, it's an opportunity to make a great first impression, set expectations on what type of content to expect and frequency, send your new contacts a welcome email to introduce yourself, say thank you, or even offer a special promotion. It's also an opportunity to ask your contact to whitelist your sender email address, meaning add your email address to their list of contacts. Also ask if they're using Gmail to drag your email from the promotions tab to their inbox. Tip number 6, avoid spammy subject lines and preview text. Avoid using all caps, extensive punctuation, and certain words like buy now, earn cash, double your income, etc. And a bonus tip, how do you know what emails are connecting with your audience? View the email reports. Specifically, when it comes to deliverability, look at the spam complaints and the bounce rates. Another bonus tip that you can take is to test your emails. And to find out how, click this video right here. Thanks, take care, and I'll see you in the next video.